Then we have one remote microphone which have a part for DV8500RM remote paging microphone which is come with the 12 keys button. Okay, and we have one zone expansion by expansion unit DV8RM keypad. If your zone is more than 12, you have more than 12 zones, we can expand it by the our expansion unit which is known as DV8RM keypad. Also, we have indications for AC, DC fault. If there is any fault, we have a LED indication in our remote microphone. If there is any AC power fault, we have AC power indication. If there is DC power, then we have DC power indication and so on. We have reset, cancel, call and call button. We have this kind of four buttons in our microphone for the announcement purpose. 8 zone selection button with 3 color LEDs indicators. Okay, we have 3 color LED indicator which show different kind of scenarios. For example, if there is paging, the LED will show green indication. If there is any fault, the LED will show yellow indication and so on. The communication with between the controller and the remote microphone is over the Cat5 or Cat6 cable up to 600 meter. Our remote paging microphone will communicate with the controller up to 600 meter without any external power supply. It will take the power supply only through the controller. It has inbuilt monitor speakers for monitoring the announcement, what is going on in the field side area. It has dip switches setting for addressing purpose. For example, if we are connecting more than one microphone in a same loop, so we can differentiate them by the dip switches by giving the different addresses in the form of binary. Then we have touchscreen remote microphone also, which have a part code DV8500TM. This microphone is work up to 120 zone. If by a single microphone, we can control 120 zones. It communicate with the controller over the communication protocol which is known as a CobraNet. And it's also support with the controller up to 600 meter distance. It has built-in monitor speaker. It can be connect 32 microphone in loop. We can connect 32 microphone in loop. It has touch screen. We can all the commands will be done by the touch screen only. And we have one talk button by which we can make the call in the selected zone. After that, this is a connection diagram of 8 zones. As you see, here is our controller, which is known as DV8500. All the zones are connected with the controller only. And this is our extension or standby class D amplifier for the redundancy part. If there is any failure in the controller of amplifier, if it's inbuilt amplifier will fail, the standby amplifier will take over the all the system.
Meeting option is star word.
We have multiple 6 BGM inputs, as I already said. It can be CD player, it can be microphone or any other.
Meeting is the
total remote microphone to the controller in the loop. For example, we have 16 zones. And so we can connect microphones in the loop with the controller.
Hello.
Okay, now these are our power amplifiers, which comes in, we have all the categories of power amplifiers, class A, B, class D, class H. We have all the categories. So first we discuss about our class AB amplifier, which comes with a series of HPA. And we have different amplifiers with the different channels and different power wattage. For example, we have one single channel 120 watt amplifier, dual channel 120 watt amplifier, single channel 240 watt amplifier, and dual channel 240 watt, and so on. Okay. These amplifiers are class AB amplifiers, which is our analog amplifiers. And we have also class D amplifiers, which comes all the variants in the single channel, dual channel, four channel with different power wattage. What is the difference between class AB and class D? It's all about is efficiency. Class D amplifiers have more efficiency than the class AB amplifiers.
हैंड ओवर करो, वो अपने पे चलाएंगे, कमांडिंग वगैरह देखते हैं वो आप, ठीक है, दो घंटे ये बैठ, दो घंटे
मम्मी
पापा दोनों कोई बात
नो. दिस इज द कनेक्शन डायग्राम ऑफ 16 जोन पावर सिस्टम. Previously, I discussed about 8 zone power system. Now this is a 16 zone power system where we use one more unit, which is our slave unit. Our slave unit, which having a power cut deviant 500 RT. The connection between controller and slave units is over the Cat6 cable or Cat5 cable, and all the zones will connect on the slave unit only. Rest of the things are same as the previous one. Now I am inviting to Farman sir to take over the session further.
नकली माल आ गया, वो चीज नहीं है.
So Kapil has explained you about the DVA8500 controller. There's applications are in corporate buildings, hospitals, hotels. We can use our controller. The advantage we got in this controller, it has inbuilt 500 watt amplifier. So you don't, if your wattage is comes under 500 watt, you don't need to consider any external amplifier. And your this system is from 8 zone to 120 zone is supportable. This controller is of 8 zone. If your system has more than 8 zones, you can add the routers of the same 8 zones. Routers are there, and adding the routers in multiples, you can expand your system to 120 zones. The connection between the controller and the router will be on Cat6, and the maximum distance is from the controller to router is also up to 500 to 600 meter. You can place your router. So if you have multiple building and the distance of the building is comes under your 600 meters, you can place the routers in different multiple buildings, and from a single control center you can control all the PA, VA, BGM system in all the multiple buildings from your controller, from your microphones. These system, you can connect 32 microphones in a single system. If you want to announce from the multiple locations, you can place your microphone on the multiple location in loop in, loop out configuration. As he explained you that these have multiple audio inputs. So if you have multiple audio inputs like CD player, AM FM tuners, and wireless mic, handle mics, you can use as a audio inputs. These controller has 6 audio inputs are there. So on the same configuration, we have our one more product, that is our voicer. Voicer G3. So all the specification will be same as the DVA8. Only the difference is the Voicer G3 controller is 6-zone controller and DVA8 is our 8-zone controller. Voicer G3, if we compare, what is the advantage of Voicer G3? You all are familiar with Bosch and other system. They have cleaner series with 6-zone. The advantages of using Voicer G3 that it has inbuilt 500 watt amplifier. So if your wattage comes under 500 watt, you don't need any amplifier. If you go with any other OEM, you have to consider the controller, then the amplifier. So if your wattage comes under 500 watt, you don't need any amplifier. If your wattage goes over 500 watt, then you can select an external amplifier for expandability. This single controller can support up to 4000 watt at 6-zone. Same is the master and router configuration are there. If you want to expand, if your zones are more than 6, you can add your routers. The routers is also of 6 zones, so it can be extended up to 120 zones. Router also has 500 watt amplifier. So if you are using our system, the external amplifier you don't need to use because enough power is provided in the controller and router itself. Then the microphone are same Voicer G3, the button microphone, and there is a touch screen microphone. If you have zones more than 20-30, you can consider that touchscreen microphone that is compact in size. You can control from that microphone up to your 120 zones. You can make announcement in a single zone, in a multiple zone, or in all zones from a single microphone, touchscreen microphone, either from the button microphone. So this system and our previous DV8 500, the terminology is the same, specification are of the same. The only difference that is of 8-zone and this is of 6-zone. Multiple control inputs are provided for the integration with fire alarm system, with your any other third party system. Priority managements are there. You can set the priority of your different inputs. Suppose generally the input from the fire alarm is at the highest priority, then the second priority we provide to this fireman microphone, then the third priority you can give to your these microphones. If you are using 4 microphone, you can set the priority of the 4 microphone, which microphone has the highest priority. So these are the advantages we are offering in a PAVA BGM system. So we talk about the controllers. Now we talk about the speakers we have for the PAVA system. So first of all, ceiling speakers, 6 watt. We have in 5-inch, 6-inch, 8-inch. We have in metal body. We have in plastic body. Both are available. Different sizes are available. These speakers are 6 watt. Multiple tappings has been there. 6 watt, 3 watt, 1.5 watt. 200 volt, two inputs are provided at 100 volt and at 70 volts. So PAVA speakers generally work on 100 volts because amplifier gives the output on the 100 volts only. So we use 100 volt. If your amplifier is giving the output on 70 volt, you can connect to our 70 volt terminal as well. Generally in PAVA system, you have seen that 6-inch ceiling speaker are very common. But we have different sizes available with us, 5-inch, 6-inch and 8-inch. In the same configuration, we have a small speaker as well. That is of 3-inch and 4-inch as well. That the size of these speaker is, if you are using in the ceiling, it will be like your LED lights, the size of LED lights. So the aesthetically, it will look very good. And it is also come with 6 watt with multiple tappings are there. So sizes are available with us. There are different sizes are there. As you can see, 3-inch, 4-inch, 5-inch, 6-inch and 8-inch. Next is our fireproof ceiling speaker. Previously, which the speaker we have seen, they don't have the fire dome on the back of the speakers. So we have the fireproof ceiling speaker as well that have the fireproof dome on the back side of the speakers. These are especially used in airports, railway stations, metros, so where we use fireproof ceiling speakers. These are available in different sizes, 5 inch, 6 inch, 8 inch. Then our wall mount speakers. So we use wall mount speaker as well for the PAVA system. So we have 6 inch speaker, 6 watt speakers, 15 watt speaker, 30 watt speakers. Basically in PAVA system, normally 6 or 10 watt speaker, wall mount speaker are used. So we have our SML series, SMS series, different kinds of indoor, these are all indoor wall mount loudspeakers. We have outdoor loudspeaker as well. You can install in the outdoor area, in your garden, in your terrace. So if you want to make announcement on the open area, we have our outdoor IP66 rated speakers that is come with 30 watt tapping, multiple designs we have available. Then horn speakers are for the parking, for the basement, for the outdoor area. Basically horn speakers are used. So we have our weatherproof horn speaker available in different wattages, 15 watt, 20 watt, 25 watt, 30 watt, 60 watt. So these are all types of speakers we use in PAVA system. Basically horn speakers are used in outdoor areas, just like parking areas or basement areas. So we can use these horn speaker in PAVA system. So if you are working for any hotels or any gardens or any amusement parks, and you can use these kind of landscape garden speakers for the PAVA and BGM system, the aesthetically it will look like very good. So for garden area, amusement park, you can consider these kind of landscape garden speakers as well for the your PAVA and BGM system. Then this is a projector speakers are also there. These are bi-directional or unidirectional, both are available. Usually these kind of speaker you see in metro stations, on the platform you will see, on railway station platform you will see these kind of speakers. These are also indoor, outdoor you can use. So their ability is to direct the sound in a single direction or dual direction. In wall speakers are also there. These are flush mount in wall speaker. You can flush these speaker in the wall. So it is available within 6 watt with us for PAVA BGM system. If you want this kind of a speaker, they are available with us. Then there is a volume controls are there. If you in PAVA system, if you are installing the speakers in some in office building, there are cabins, so you can install these volume controllers are there. They can adjust the volume of the BGM if they want, and they are relay based. So once any fire or any priority message has been played through the controller, they will trigger and they will automatically, their volume has been increased. So if any person has decreased the volume through the volume controller, it doesn't mean in the fire evacuation they will not get the messages. They will get the messages once their relay is triggered, they automatically set to a desirable volume. So the volume is, volume controller, we have 6 watt, 30 watt, 100 watt. So as per your zone or speaker wattage, you have to select the volume controller for your different areas. Just like cabins you can consider, or conference or meeting rooms, you can consider if you have installed the PA and BGM speakers there. So this is all the speakers and the controller we have explained you. This can be used for your corporate buildings, hotels, where multiple zones you require different type of speaker, I have explained. Then we have one controller, our BACC. Basically, this is widely used in airports. The configuration of PA-VA system in airport are very different. So our controller BACC will comply all the required specification or application in airports. So in airports or metro or railway station, there are some standards we need to follow in PA-VA system. First is dual circuit and loudspeaker circuit failure. Dual circuit means in each zone there will be a dual circuit. Suppose on platform area there are 40 speakers. If I connected with all the speakers with a single speaker line, if any speaker line will be damaged, then all the speakers will go off and there will be no announcement there. So to get the fifth redundancy on that part, you have to take dual circuit line for each zone. 50% of the speaker will be connected to the one line and 50% speaker will be connected to the other line. So in case any cable will be damaged, the announcement in that zone that have the 50% redundancy, and that must comply in airports, railways, metros, big industries. EN54 approved loudspeaker. All the loudspeakers must be EN54 approved. Single amplifier failure. In this, if any amplifier fails, the zone should not stop the announcement. The amplifier should not affect any announcement on zone. For that failure, we have to provide backup amplifiers. So any amplifier will be phased, backup amplifier automatically take over the charge of that amplifiers. 5 dBA above background noise in fire condition. So in fire condition, there should be a programming in your controller. The SPL level of your announcement should increase by 5 dBA. Intelligibility of your system must be more than 0.5 of all the announcement. Monitoring automatic gain control. Monitoring of all the equipment is necessary. Your all equipment should be monitor on your controller, on your software dashboard. Automatic gain control. If we talk about metros, railways, airports, we cannot define the ambient noise level, because sometimes the rush is very high, the ambient noise level automatically will go higher, and sometimes rush are very low, so the ambient noise is very low. So you do have to consider ambient noise microphones that have sense the ambient noise of the surrounding and increase or decrease the volume of the speaker automatically. So this is called automatic gain control. So for that, you have to install noise sensing microphone in different zones so that they can sense the noise level, ambient noise level, and adjust the volume of the speaker. Secondary power supply, all the equipment should have dual power supply. In case of one is failure, there should be a secondary power supply working with it so that equipments will not get off. Priority level, different priority levels should be there. In our controller, there are 255 priority levels are there. You can define 255 priorities in our system. Just like fire evacuation on first, then emergency on second, then there is a microphone in the control room as third, then the microphone in the gates are the fourth. These kind of priority levels you have to define in the PA-VA system. So this is our VSC controller. The major difference between this controller and the above controllers we have explained, this can work as an hot redundancy controller. You can connect two controllers at the same time. If one controller is failed, all the controls will be automatically taken care by the second controller. That we call primary and secondary. Initially, the primary controller will take all the controls. If in any condition primary controller will get failed, all the controls will be taken care by the secondary controller. That is a standard 1+1 hot by standby controllers. Everyone need to use on airports, metros. So these controllers have built-in fire alarm messages. There are the redundancy is so important in these areas. We are providing two SD cards. One is primary SD card and one is secondary. If any kind in any situation, primary SD card is failed, secondary SD card will work. Simultaneously, two cards for BGM. Then built-in 4 MP3 modules, audio inputs are there. You can connect your third party, any audio source to this controller. Fireman microphones will be there to make any emergency announcement from the controller. You can make through the fireman announcement. External trigger for alarm and commercial messages. There are control inputs are there. You can integrate with fire alarm systems, CCTV, PBX, with any third party system with this controller. This has the touch screen display in this, where you can see all the, you can check health of all the equipment. You can monitor your loudspeaker line here as well. This is an emergency button. In any case, if there is an emergency, you can press this button and the automatically announcement will be played in all the zones. This will monitor your loudspeaker line monitoring. DC battery backup is there. External volume control you can place. Equipment failure contact output. That is, I explained you that there will be two controllers. If one fails, another will take over that controls. So this is the basic architecture working of this controller. The controller will be connected to your local area network. There is a router for the zone expansion. This system can be expanded to 256 zone by adding this router. This router is 8 zone router. You can add multiple routers to expand your zones. All the amplifier will be connected to these routers only. Your microphones will be connected to directly to the Ethernet. You can place anywhere your microphone on your network. You can make announcement multiple zones, all zones, single zones. Then there is a software on the network. You can install your software in any of your PC, laptop. You can make announcement as well from your software as well. There is a scheduling option is there. You can schedule the announcement that at this time, this announcement should be played. At this time, this announcement should be played. So scheduling you can do. And then there is a log event is there. All the events that is occur in our system, you can check in our log files in your software. There will be a log are available at what time, which announcement is played to which zone, at what time, which equipment is failed, at what time, which loudspeaker line is failed. So any kind of failure or event occur in your system, you can check your logs in your system. Secondly, you can make announcement from your software as well. There is a three kinds of announcement available in this: emergency, alert, and BGM as well. So this is the basic architecture of the working of this controller, this VACC controller. This is the CCM at the router unit. I explained you about this. This is for the 8 zones. It can control 8 zones. If you have more than 8 zones, you have to add these routers to your system. So in this router, there is a one backup amplifier port will be there for the 8 zones. You are using suppose 8 amplifiers. If any one of the amplifier will fail, these the backup amplifier will automatically take over the failure amplifier. Each there is a AB wiring is available with us. As I explained you, for the zone redundancy, 50% redundancy will be providing to all the zones. So AB wiring for each zone will be available. 8 local audio inputs are also available. You can connect a single button microphone to a specific to any zone. So you can announce from a single button as well. So this is the microphone PMC8TM. This is a touch screen microphone. We have from a single microphone, you can configure 256 zone. You can make announcement to any of the from any of the zones through this microphone. This has to be directly connected to your network. There is no need to direct connection with the controller. So the expandability is very much higher in here because you can place anywhere over the network. This microphone in the rear panel, we are providing you two. One is record output and one is audio input. Locally, you can connect any audio input in this microphone. Suppose I connected my mobile through aux cable in this microphone and I selected a song from my mobile, I can play that song in any zones or in multiple zones or in all zones. There is a record output. You can connect there your headphone and you can monitor all the announcements that are going on in your system. And the redundancy is so important that in this there are two Ethernet connection has been provided. One is primary, one is secondary. In case primary has failed, secondary will work. So chances of failure is very, very, very rare in this system. So this is button microphone. If your zones are very less, you can use button microphone as well. These are 8 key button microphones. This has also dual redundancy, Ethernet switches for connectivity, audio input for monitoring. And if you have more than 8 zones, you can add these keypad to these microphones. Announcement will be made all zones, single zones and multiple zones. And in this system, there is a one advantage is you can broadcast 12 messages to 12 different zones simultaneously. Sorry, 16 simultaneously message you can play in 16 different zones. This specification you will not get in any other OEM brand. Maximum they will give you 4 to 8 simultaneously messages. We will offer, our system will offer you 16 simultaneously messages can be played in 16 different zones. This is the ambient noise sensing microphone that I explained to you, that automatic gain control. These microphone will sense your ambient noise level and adjust the volume of your speaker as per the ambient noise level. Suppose in nights, if we talk about in night, the ambient noise is very less. So the volume level of the announcement, we will not require that much. So they will automatically lower down the volume of the speakers. When the noise, ambient noise is getting higher, they will automatically increase the volume of your speaker. So that is called ambience noise sensing microphone. Because the traffic in airports, metros varies at different times. Sometimes the traffic is very high. When the traffic is very high, the ambient noise is very high. We need the more volume. When the traffic is very low, ambient noise is very low. We don't need much volume in the sound. So the volume of your speaker will be automatically adjusted. So this is a complete general architecture of an airport, where you can see there are two same controllers are there. One is primary and one is secondary. If one is failed, this will automatically take all the controls and without failure in the system. Then all your router is connected to the switch. You can make the warning from these routers, each router 8 zones. If you have more than 8 zones, you have to add the multiple routers. You can add multiple number of microphones. Button microphone will be connected to the controller only, and touch screen microphone will connect to the switch only. Then our ambient noise sensing microphones are connected for the automatic gain control, to control the volume of the speakers as per your ambient noise. So these ambient noise sensing microphone need to be used. You can see there are in each zone there will be AB wiring is there, so that 50% redundancy can be acquired. So this is our the complete architecture we use in airports, in metros, in railway station, or in any building you want this kind of redundancy or this kind of PAVS system standard you want, then you have to go for these systems. So this is all about the audiovisual and PAVS system. And if you have any query regarding anything, you can write us on our email IDs that is given on the screens. If you have any queries or any requirement of any system or any queries regarding any product, you can write us on these emails. So that is all about our today's presentations. And thank you all of you for joining us here and for your valuable time.